My name is Ann Wright. I am a panelist in absentia. I am here in El Salvador, and I send my regrets for not being in person at the conference on the presidency of George W. Bush. But I am here in El Salvador because of a meeting we've had with the president of El Salvador on a very important issue concerning the U.S. military and the Salvadorian military and issues of human rights. And that kind of feeds into my presentation today on the moral, ethical, and legal consequences of working in the Bush administration. I am a retired U.S. Army colonel. I spent 29 years in the U.S. military. I also was a U.S. diplomat for 16 years and served in U.S. embassies in Nicaragua, Grenada, Somalia, Uzbekistan, Kyrgyzstan, Sierra Leone. I helped reopen the U.S. Embassy in Kabul, Afghanistan in December of 2001 and stayed there for about 5 months. I went on then to my next assignment, which was the Deputy Chief of Mission or Deputy Ambassador for the U.S. Embassy in Mongolia. And it was there in 2003 that I ultimately ended my career with the U.S. government. After nearly 40 years in the U.S. government, I resigned in opposition to the Bush administration's declaration of war on Iraq. And I did that because I felt it was an illegal war. It did not comply with the laws of war. There was no UN declaration that Iraq was an international a problem that had to be solved by international military operations. And in fact, my boss, Colin Powell, had made such an extensive presentation to the UN Security Council on the threats coming from Iraq, yet the United Nations Security Council did not vote for military operations in Iraq. That caused a great challenge for those of us that were working in the Bush administration. Three of us ultimately resigned over it, only three, but I can tell you that there were thousands, tens of thousands of people in the U.S. government that were very, very conflicted over that decision to go to war in Iraq. Each of the three of us that resigned received hundreds of emails from colleagues in the U.S. government saying, "You're doing the right thing by resigning because this is an illegal war. It is going to be horrific for the people of Iraq for sure, but also for the national security of the United States, that the United States one more time is going to be seen as the invader and occupier of a oil-rich Arab Muslim country, and one that had not attacked the United States in 9/11. So the decision to resign, the ethical and moral decision to end my service to the United States because of this war and because of the legal ramifications of this war were things that I have grappled with really for the next 12 years. Other people have grappled with other aspects of the fallout from the war on Iraq and from other Bush administration policies. If we look at the numbers of people who have actually gone to jail for having revealed to the American public the extent of the incarceration of prisoners that we have had, the long-term incarceration of prisoners, the torture that happened to prisoners in U.S. prisons in Afghanistan and in Iraq, in Bagram, in Abu Ghraib, and then in Guantanamo. The moral crisis that people have had in dealing with policies of the Bush administration that were legal, that were illegal. We knew they were illegal, and yet many of them then were changed and ratified by the U.S. Congress to say that torture is no longer torture. But we know in our own hearts, in our own minds, in our own conscience, we know what is right and what is wrong. That is one of the legacies now that we have of the Bush administration, where the consciences of people in the government are coming into conflict with what the policies of administrations are. And to be fair about this whole thing, even though we're not criticized, this is to be with the Bush administration, I'm an equal opportunity critic. The Obama administration on its assassin drone program and its expansion of the NSA eavesdropping and spying on American citizens and citizens around the world. The degradation of privacy that we've seen under first the Bush administration and the Obama administration are things that should be giving pause to every government employee that we have. And so this crisis of the morality, the ethical considerations and the legal considerations of working for administrations as they take us into war are something that I hope that will be debated very strongly in the conference today. And with that, I want to thank you very much to the organizers for having selected my topic to be a part of this conference. And I apologize again for not being there in person, but I wish you the very best. Thank you.